opposite of the road and gushing into my nostrils. All I could see was the leaves hitting my face as I ran through the rainforest. I suddenly hit a very hard leaf, which felt like a tree, and I could taste the blood in my mouth. We were too weak to continue, and we left the road in peace. Dang it, we should have had that road, and Doug was annoyed. I know, but the road was 10 times faster than us. I still had blood in my mouth when I was walking. After a while, it became late, and Doug was sitting with me, which became a deep sleep. Doug quickly tried to open his eyes the next morning. He looked down, and he saw that he was tied up. Brian, he started to panic. I woke up. Then, in the spur of a moment, a man jumped out of the tree. I thought I was going to die a horrible death, and that's when he started talking. I am Ahut, the leader of the Shuar tribe, and the man in an imposing look on his face. My men found you sleeping in our territory and we spared you, Ahut said. I will free you if you will never search for your old tribe, and you will live with us, the men declared. Keep mine, accepting sleep, whatever. Doug didn't really agree with me, despite his answer. Well, now we both have to give you a new name and hut, Ahut said happily, while he ordered them to be untied. You look like a warrior. Your new name is Ahiga, which in your language means fight, so I will explain. You look like a hunter. Ahut was pointing at Doug. You will be named Dayani, which in your language means eagle, he declared. We followed her, Triborn, and she brought us to our hut while Dayani started whispering. Nice plan. When we get to the hut, we will stitch these guys. We have to stay. We gave our words, I replied. What? Do you want to stay? I'm ditching these guys first chance I get, Dayani argued. They kept arguing until they got to their hut. They went inside without a word and fell asleep. The next day I woke up and said good morning to Dayani and dressed. Then I noticed that he wasn't there. I rushed outside and called by his old name. Doug, Doug, I shouted. In my heart I already knew that he was dead because he had tried to run from the Shuar tribe. How could I be so stupid, I thought, while the tears went down my cheeks and I fell to my knees in the feet. My best and only friend was dead. Every tribe in the area would know again that the Shuar are not weak or scared to kill. Marshal Piro, my own tribe. Should I try to go back, or should I stay here? If I went back at any point, it had to be soon. My old tribe saw the Shuar as an enemy, which would include me. I knew that the Marshal Piro was all history, just like Dayani was. I was practicing my bow and arrow skills on the tree when I heard, hey, let's go, the lunch is ready. Ahut was calling out to his best warrior, me, to join him for lunch. I sat by the hiring people because I was a great Shuar warrior. But what made me special was that I lost Dayani and I'm still taking out my anger because he loved me. Cheers, I suddenly heard us all say. A great day of practice so far. A super strong team of conversation. I was mentally back at lunch and required. All you do is be the snake in the bushes. Everyone laughed at my comrades and for us. Just kidding, I quickly. Hey, my name stands for a snake, which is what I strive to be like. A super had a proud face on his, and a proud look on his face. We all looked back when we got the alert. There was another tribe invading us. Everybody find your weapons and take cover, Albert whispered. I got my knife and spear. I knew how to handle them expertly. I took my spear behind the tree. I saw the first man invading. I aimed at him with my spear and waited for a loose attack whistle. There it was, the attack whistle. I suddenly froze. It wasn't just any tribe invading us. It was the Marshal Piro, my old tribe, which I thought I would never see again. They were dodging the branches and crouching behind the trees and bushes, as if the open air burned them. It looked like one person coming at me from hundreds of directions, and all of them started charging at me without knowing I was there. It was as if they thought I was the only man in the tribe. Arrows started piercing air and flesh. I could hear the blood splattering on the leaves drop by drop in slow motion. Which community should I go and fight with? I thought myself. I thought about myself and how people from both tribes saw me as a person. I knew that the tribes didn't see the similarities, just the differences. All of these thoughts were going through my mind in a split second, which made me jump out the tree and run. Unexpectedly, I heard 3 sets of footsteps behind me. These belonged to Ascook, Ahut, and what seemed like to be like Dayani. Then when I looked twice, I saw that it was Dayani's brother. The force of us kept sprinting until it came to a halt. Why are you guys following me? I asked desperately to know while I was still panting from all
best friend Diana, you're lying. I'm getting for what he did. That wasn't my order, it was my second in command, he explained. What about you, Oscar? Why did you run away? I didn't really believe others. I ran away from the Mushroom Hero tribe, and Evan found me. More people joined us until we created the Schwab tribe, and we all looked at Diana's brother, Luke. Why are you here, Luke? I asked, happy to see. I saw you run and I followed you, Luke replied. I hope you gave Luke the name Anapi, which meant brave. Together we went through the chapter of four surviving. More people started joining.